State boys basketball team. This group of boys finished their season with an impressive record of 25-3. Along the way, they won the Tazoo Conference Championship by going 7-0. They won their regional, beating a tough Metamora Redbird team in a close game, 41-38. They then defeated Warrensburg Latham, 35-16, to win their sectional and earn a trip to the IASA 3A State Finals. In their first game at state, the Warriors beat East St. Louis Lincoln in the Elite Eight by a score of 36-28. They then lost to Harvard in the Final Four, 22-21 to Monticello in the final seconds. But they then capped off their season by beating Teutopolis, 31-22, to take third place in the state of Illinois. Let's meet the players and coaches. Number one, Kimber Pasquini. Number four, Alex Burr. Give us a wave. Number five, Jackson Brown. Number 10, Graham Bittner. They're pretty shy, and they're pretty good. Number 12, Mason Perry. Number 14, Ashton Taylor. Number 20, Briggs Busey. Number 21, Cooper Sheets. Number 22, Eli Young. Number 23, Logan Vasquez. Number 24, Keon Allen. Number 30, Gavin Geyer. Number 32, Lucas Alward. And number 33, Mason Neal. The manager this year, Evan Oberle. Scorekeeper, Tom Pisano. Assistant coach, our very own senior, Ryan Russell. And head coach, Mr. Russ Gary. Congratulations, Warriors, on a great season. Can't wait to become Redbirds. I see Coach Reeves have already met each of you. Let's hear it for your 7th grade 3A IESA 3rd place Jupertown Mills Warriors. Congratulations, boys.
We are live here from Metamora for tonight's Mid-Illini Conference matchup between the Metamora Redbirds and the Morton Potters. It's game 30 of the year here on February 15th. Good evening. Welcome to Redbird Replay. Colton Kaler alongside Scott Kirker here from Tepke Gym on the campus of Metamora Township High School. Scott, a good one here tonight on our hands. A little bit of formality. Redbirds have already clinched the Mid-Illini Conference Championship, but still business to take care of here against a team that we're probably not good friends with.
No, and that little bit of rivalry was probably enhanced a little bit when we played over there back before Christmas. When they walked off the court and we went up and we dunked it with about 4 or 5 seconds left to go. But they walked off the court with what, 50 seconds to go in the ball game. And you know, if they didn't want us to dunk or they didn't want us to score, then they should have stayed on the court, because we were out, we were just going to play catch and game was over. It was an 18-point lead. But they walked off the court, and when you do that, you got to just take whatever happens after that.
Redbirds come in at 23-6 on the year, 12-1 in the Mid-Illini, looking to tie their program best record of 13-1 in the Mid-Illini, going back to the 2015-16 season, that Nate Cannell senior-led team. They went 13-1. Their lone loss was at Washington that year as well. That team Metamora here tonight could tie that record. So looking for a little bit of history in the making as well. But as mentioned, that final, that last meeting between these two teams, 62-42, Metamora with the victory on December 17th. It was a very good game all around. Great game by Metamora, the core four. Ethan Kaiser just come back, I believe, from his sickness injury stint there. So he came back, had a nice game that night. But Redbirds are clicking right now. 12 of their last 13 they've won. They're on an 11-game winning streak. Just playing great ball. And if you think about it, Metamora lost their first three games of the season, 0-3. Since November 26th, Metamora is 23-3 since that very moment.
And we've played some pretty good teams. You got Rock Island in there, Bradley Bourbonnais, Oak Park,
even
River Forest.
East St. Louis that you lost to.
Yeah.
That's a very impressive run here by Metamora. Again, the core four, Schroeder, Kaiser, Swanson, Tucker, they've all been big. They've all had their performances, their moments. Going back to Friday night, the big emotional win over Washington to clinch. That was pretty well Zach Schroeder and Ethan Kaiser. Kaiser pretty well owned the fourth quarter. Yeah. Zach owned the third quarter. That was their second half.
Yeah, and I there's been times this year where they've all had their been in the limelight. They've carried the team on their backs. Coach talked about it, and we'll talk to him in just a few minutes, but he talked about how, he doesn't think we've played our best basketball yet. And, we maybe haven't yet. And when we do, wow.
Looking at the series between Metamora and Morton, the Redbirds have won the last four. The 20-point blowout earlier this year. You go back last year to COVID, had that amazing miracle on a Saturday morning over at the Potter Dome. The game-winning three by Solomon Schwarz off the purposely missed free throw by Zach Schroeder. They won the previous matchup against Metamora as well that year, and then I believe we actually beat them in the first round of the Middle Illinois Conference Tournament last year. That one got a little hairy as well. Yep. It had a few ejections with less than 50 people in the gym, so that one, it was interesting, and it's going to be interesting. I really wonder if there's going to be a little bit of bad blood here tonight.
Well, there might be, but you know what? You got to be careful because, Metamora does have one more game on the schedule, but, weather permitting, that game could get canceled Thursday night.
And it would not be surprising if that one was not made up either.
No, it may not be, but so it's going to be a little bit tricky. We're just about 30 seconds away from the national anthem and the starting lineups. But I take this time now and talk to the Redbird head coach. Well, here we are once again with Metamora head coach Danny Greaves. Coach, another packed house tonight.
Wow. I'll tell you what, isn't this great?
Oh, this is fantastic.
The atmosphere is electric.
Big win by the sophomore game or by the sophomore team tonight. Kind of sets you in a good start to the evening.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's a pride game. Even though we've already won the conference, it was a knockdown drag out over there, and I'm sure it's going to be that way again tonight.
Yeah, it was a 20-point win for you over there. And it is a pride game. You want to go through, and with just one loss, that would be pretty impressive.
Well, we're looking forward to that, and I hope that's what happens.
Yeah,
we're ready.
You had a big emotional game Friday night in front of a packed house that night. Big crowd watched us live on TV. They'll watch us again tonight. But then you play probably your second biggest rival in the Morton Potters here tonight.
You can probably say that is the second best. And you know what? We're just going to go out there and play our game, Metamora game plan A, let the chips fall where they may, and we'll just get after it. I think you're going to like the outcome.
Yeah, I think so too. Any changes in your starting lineup tonight?
We'll probably go with the same lineup.
Yeah, if it's not broke, don't fix it.
One senior, three juniors, and a freshman sounds kind of good, don't it?
Yeah, it does. Morton's been on a little bit of a roll. They've played some pretty good basketball here as of late. So it's probably not going to be an easy game for you, but you don't want that late this year anyway.
Well, I'll tell you what, they are playing their best, and I think we are too. The great thing is, they're pretty close to hitting their ceiling, and I think we got a little ways to go.
Yeah, I thought so too. You guys have shown signs of playing really, really well. But you're right. I think four quarters, you're probably just starting to hit your stride.
Well, it's kind of nice to have a little depth and have everybody healthy and available. You know, I always tell our guys we're only as strong as the weakest link. And when you got everybody there, you know, it sure does make it better.
Yeah, your weakest link is still pretty good ball player.
Yeah, it is.
Well, Coach, we'll let you get going here. You're going to have a little pre-game show by the dance team and the cheerleaders. But, Coach, last home game, and, boy, it'd be nice to come out of it with a big W.
Well, that's the game plan, I guarantee you.
All right, Coach. Well, let's go. Good luck.
Thank you so much, man. I appreciate you. Thank you.
Welcome back inside Tepke Gym. Just about set for the starting lineups, national anthem, and pregame ceremony. So we'll hand over to PA Gary Baranowski.
Good evening, basketball fans, and welcome to Metamora High School, tonight's Mid-Illini Conference matchup between the visiting Potters of Morton High School and your Metamora Redbirds. At this time, we ask that you please stand and face the flag as Metamora senior Meg Seco sings our national anthem. Senior guard, number 11,
Well, Colton, that was a pretty exciting starting lineup.
There you have it. Starters for both teams. Same starting lineup for the Redbirds as Friday night. Matthew Zobrist gets the nod again. So it'll be Zobrist, Schroeder, Kaiser, Swanson, and Tucker for the Redbirds. For Morton, you had Ben Carter, Bo Durbin, Gus Rugard, Seth Glatz got a nice warm welcome here. And I believe the last one is Tate Rowley. Yes, it is. Tucker up early, got it to go. Gets the Redbirds on the board early. 2-0, Metamora on the first possession of the game.
Tucker with that toughness, that I love that. You know, he gets beat up in every game, so. I wonder if he could make a shot without getting bumped.
Seth Glatz on the drive, no dice.
Kaiser
rebound, Kaiser. I think as long as there's not football on the court tonight, we'll be all right. Three up, no good from Tucker. Glatz quickly the other way, up and in. He ties it up at two. He's a guy I wouldn't want to get in front of on a football field, and a guy I probably wouldn't want to get in front of on a basketball court either. When he gets going downhill, he definitely has that running back speed and that strength. Not fun either way. Tucker, pump fake. Love to see Metamora get Zobrist a look early. Kaiser goes over the top to Swanson. Finds Tucker.
There it is.
Zobrist open three. No good. Looked good. Couldn't get to go. The heart and soul of this Morton team. Right there with the ball, Bo Durbin. Morton comes in at 19-6 on the season. Or no, excuse me, 18-9. Glatz going to work again on Schroeder. Metamora wanted to travel, and they're going to get a foul, yep, on Kaiser. He was reaching.
Yep.
Durbin with it off the inbounds pass. He's got nothing. He's able to find Carter late. Close to a 5-second count. Durbin on the drive. Pump fake. Up. No good. Rebound Zobrist. Morton. Matt Franks. Still at the helm. Three ball on the way.
Good.
Zach Schroeder gives Metamora the 5-2 lead. 5:20 left to play here in the opening corner. But as I was saying, Matt Franks has been at Morton for quite some time now.
He'd been there a few years. It's hard to believe, though, the guy with the most time in the middle Illini. Ooh, there's an air ball.
Three ball air ball by Seth Glatz.
Is Danny Greaves.
Pump fake Zach Schroeder up. Ooh. No good. The other line to shoot, too.
Danny Greaves with the longest tenure in the middle Illini.
Seth Glatz with the foul. I think Dunlap's had as almost as many coaches as Coach Greaves has been here.
Yeah, they've gone through
numerous
coaches.
First one up and
kinda
good from Schroeder.
Kind of like the coach of the week. It was Kevin Brown, now Eric Schimmelhorn over there.
At Washington, yep.
Schroeder with both. 7-2 Redbirds. 5 minutes to go. First quarter. Oh, yes. Nice job by Tyson Swanson.
Durbin creates separation on the drive. Tucker came up hobbling a little bit. He still is. Schroeder with the rebound. Swanson with the drive. Three ball Ethan Kaiser up too strong, but Schroeder right there again. Swanson up, was fouled, no call. A lot of contact there, in my opinion. We get our first sub. Up and under, got it. That's Gus Rugard. Makes it 7-4. Tyler Mason is set to check in at the next dead ball.
Will he be coming in for Tucker?
Possibly. Schroeder pump fake drive, tough shot, can't get it to go. Rebound Swanson, he was right there. Fought through the contact again, no call. Coach Greaves is begging for one right now.
I'm not sure there was a foul there, was it?
Yeah, there was a lot of contact on that offside on the player on the far side.
Seth Glatz could have gone right into the lane and
He traveled. About the third time he had traveled. Metamora finally gets the call, but that will be the mask timeout, or what was known as the mask timeout. 3:22 left to play here in the opening quarter. Metamora with the 7-4 lead over Morton.
You know, Tyler Mason comes in for Matthews Obus.
How tough is it, you know, as a player tonight? You've already got the Middle Illini wrapped up. You still got one more conference game. You know, it's just for formality.
It's
more
pride.
Than anything.
It's pride.
It is.
And Coach Greaves talked about that. It's pride. And this is a team that has a lot of pride. And as you can see, you know, we're up 7-4. We haven't backed down. We came out to win this game. You can tell, you know, if it was just a game we were just going to play through and play the formality, we'd have had maybe all five seniors start.
Yeah.
But we came out and we had, you know, our normal starting lineup. You want to go into the postseason with some momentum.
11 in a row right now. That is that's some momentum right there. Got one more game possibly Thursday night at IVC. A lot going on around here at the high school. I got here at about 6 o'clock, and that parking lot was already full.
Well, look at the crowd we have here.
Back-to-back sold-out crowds. They were not quite at full capacity, but Pep Band is here tonight. Out of the timeout, no more ball with Schroeder, Tucker, Swanson, Mason, and Kaiser on the court. A couple subs for the Potters. Lane Kaufman and Ethan Hurst come in the lineup. They're going to go right underneath Swanson, left hook, but he was fouled. Yep. Tate Rowley will pick that one up, and Swanson will go to the line to shoot a pair.
I like that matchup for Metamora down low because Tyson Swanson's so crafty down there. They're either going to foul him or he's going to get some easy buckets.
That was Wes Goodman that came in, not Ethan Hurst. 32,
Goodman,
not 33.
The freshman. And gets the second
one up and good. Makes it 8-4, 3:08 left to play here in the opening quarter. Redbirds with a little full court pressure on Rugard. They're going to go to Durbin. Rowley, great defense by Tucker, but Rowley's able to get it up and in, 8-6. Morton in his zone now. Skip past Tucker. Everybody's going to work around the perimeter a little bit here. Low post. Tyson Swanson dives.
Go. Oh, boy.
Good basket there on the feed from Schroeder.
Dissected that zone right there. 10-6 Redbirds. 2:10 to go, first quarter.
Seen a lot of screen action here early from the Potters. Lane Kaufman on the drive. Arm came down to Schroeder, and he got it. I'm not saying Schroeder didn't foul, but I'm not saying it's being called at the other end. So it's got to be both ways.
10-9 Redbirds with 1:57 to go first quarter. Redbirds with that narrow one-point lead. They're back to the man-to-man.
Say Morton quickly out of that zone. Rowley and Swanson battling down low. Pump fake Kaiser. Good defense there from Gudeman. Yeah, hand check right there. That'll get a whistle. The third team foul on Morton.
1:13 to go. First quarter. Redbirds up 10-9.
Three ball on the way, short.
Ooh, boy, it looked good going up.
I think Swanson got hit on the hand a little bit. No reason for a foul, but enough to affect the shot. You've got that defender closing out quick. Morton might hold for one.
Oh, he traveled.
He traveled, yep. Matt Franks not happy with the call. Tucker had that one poked away, but luckily Mason's right there. Good active hands from Bo Durbin. 25 ticks left here in the opening quarter. Redbirds likely to hold for the last shot. Ethan Kaiser was there on the dump down. They couldn't get it. 3-2 floater. No.
Oh, and Mason's going to get a rebound for that.
At the end of one, Metamora with the slim lead, 10-9.
Take this time to thank our sponsors. Angie Powers with Keller Williams Premier Realty, Black and Brown Attorneys, Commerce Bank, Kevin Kyle at Edward Jones, Germantown Grill, Goodfield State Bank, Logo Wear, Mason Funeral Home, Metamora McDonald's, Italian Feast, MVP Mobile DJ Service, Snyder Village, and Zobrist Insurance. Maybe tomorrow is gonna be a perfect day.
Maybe tomorrow it'll be a perfect day. Be going to the grill after this game.
The place to go.
It'll be Morton Ball when we start the second quarter. So what do you think of that first quarter so far?
You know,
kind of a feeling out process a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, had a few shots, didn't make.
What was the score at the end of the first quarter of the first game?
I wasn't there for the first game.
Yeah.
I missed the fireworks over at the Potter Box.
Yep.
A mystery still to be named. They call it the dome, but they play in a box.
Yes.
I'm no geometry shapes. I'm not, you know, I wasn't
good
with that.
No
architect, but I do know when a dome is a dome and a box is a box.
And it is a box.
And it is a box.
It's no different than our gym.
But I digress. Morton with the ball here to start the second quarter.
Metamora comes out with
starting lineup. No, excuse me, it's not. Great block there by Zobrist. Zobrist. They come out with Mason, Zobrist, Schroeder, Swanson, and Kaiser. Got Durbin, Gudeman, Ben Carter, Rugard, and Lane Kaufman. Three no good from Kaiser.
Still a good looking shot.
Two subs quickly up off the bench for Morton. Kaufman with the hesitation. Turnaround, couldn't get it. Rebound, Schroeder.
Schroeder with three rebounds already. 5 points.
On the drive.
Oh, boy.
Can't get it. He traveled, but it doesn't matter because it was a block and rebound to Swanson. Kaiser lay in, got it.
Well, that was nice. That was nice.
Breaks a little bit of a scoring drought. 12-9, Metamora. 6:15 left to play in the first half.
Devin Dunn up off the Redbird bench.
Ben Carter on the drive, turnaround floater, short. But he's able to get the rebound. Just out-hustled Kaiser there for that one.
Oh, nice job by Mason. Tucker will come back in also.
Lane Kaufman gonna try his luck, he hits.
And he'll tie it up at 12. 5:30 to go, first half. Redbirds and Potters tied up at 12.
Been a slow start here for the Redbirds. Schroeder on the drive, and he was fouled. They got the call that time. Lane Kaufman will pick up that foul. Fourth Potter foul. First one up and good.
Devin Dunn comes in for Tyler Mason.
Second one rattles at home, so 14-12. Metamora with the lead.
Tucker will come in for Zach Schroeder.
5:11 left to play here in the first half.
Redbirds with that 2-point lead, 14-12.
Three on the way, Tate Rowley. No, rebound Kaiser. And he throws it away, but it was tipped, and we're going to stay here. Coach Franks is still arguing with that call.
It was tipped.
Tucker with the drive. That's going to be going the other way.
With the travel.
I had to turn over the other. Either way, it's going to be a turnover. I would have called the charge personally because you got to have the ball to travel.
There was really no place for him to go there.
Yeah, it was a great defensive play by Morton because I think Metamora probably going to get lucky with that because probably should have been a foul on Tucker. Bo Durbin going to slice up the defense, get to the rim, but miss badly.
Swanson with the rebound.
And he traveled.
Yep.
That's the third Redbird turnover, back-to-back possessions with one. And that'll get us a masked timeout. So 3:53 left to play here in the first half. Metamora with the slim 14-12 lead.
Official media timeout.
I'd like to see the IHSA stick with it next year and use it as a media timeout. You've got enough. We're at the age now where a lot of these games are being used on YouTube, Clutch, you know, one way or another. There's a streaming form of some sort, MTCO. It is nice to have a media timeout per se.
Yeah, it is. I think most coaches do like it. I would imagine you're right. I imagine they'll keep that. That's the one thing they'll keep. That's the only thing they've kept, really.
Yes. Again, busy times here at Metamora. Last night had the first round, the semifinals of the girls' 3A regional. Metamora lost a tough one
overtime.
In overtime. 50-49 lost to Washington. Redbirds had multiple chances down the stretch to pull that one out, and sometimes the ball just doesn't bounce your way.
Yeah.
And it's how it goes in a very tough, loaded regional. But that regional championship Thursday night here at Tepke Gym, Washington and Peoria, Notre Dame. That's going to be a good game.
So it'll be Morton ball after the media timeout.
Bo Durbin tried backing down Dunn, passes it out. Tate Rowley on a drive. Oh,
that's a gift.
They're going to get Seth Glatz with that one.
Maybe he pushed off with the arm or something, but
I saw a little bit drop of the shoulder, but I didn't think Tucker was in front of him.
No,
I thought he was more
either
to the side.
Yeah.
And Matt Franks has got a right to not be happy with that one.
That's Glatz's second, so he'll be done for probably the first half.
Redbirds got a chance to extend this lead here. Tucker on the drive, can't get it to go. Swanson right there for it. Finds an open Matthew Zobrist, three.
Good!
Big three, Matthew
Zobrist. What a
Zobrist
job by Tyson Swanson, though. Just muscled that a ball away from the three Morton players.
The first of hopeful many threes that we'll see out of Zobrist. Three no good, Rowley, rebound Zobrist. They're gonna find a wide open Drew Tucker for three, no good.
17-12 Redbirds, 4:45 or 2:45 to go in the first half. 17-12 Redbirds.
Kaufman on the drive,
oh,
yep, got the arm
yeah,
coming
I think
down.
You're right. I think you're right. Pretty good defense, but yeah, I go along with that too.
That'll send Lane Kaufman in the line to shoot two. First one up and clanked.
Schroeder comes in for Devin Dunn.
And the second one's up and good, makes it 17-13, 2:34 left to play here in the first half. Turn that one over. Good defense by Carter to slip right through there. Lane Kaufman goes right around the Redbird defense up and in, makes it 17-15.
2-point lead for the Redbirds. That might be the easiest bucket they've had all night, other than that one that Durbin just kind of clanked.
And Morton's being very aggressive. It'd be time for a backdoor cut here. They're overplaying everything.
Zobras are being guarded by Durbin.
Schroeder dribbles that one off his knee. Very sloppy play here with 1:33 left to play. Ben Carter on the drive.
Rebound
Schroeder. And how's there no foul there? Yeah. And there is.
Give Schroeder a rebound on that, too. Well, the referee down here, I think he blew the whistle out of his mouth first because he had to catch it. Tyler Mason comes in for Matthew Zobrist. 1:26 first half. Redbirds up 17-15. Will we hold for one shot?
No. We'll work for a shot, but I don't think we'll hold for one. Tyler Mason can't handle it. Kind of an awkward place to catch that one.
Yeah.
Now Morton might have a chance to tie it or take the lead going into the halftime break if they decide to hold for one. Gus Rugard on the drive. No, and there was a foul.
I think they're getting Mason. Oh, yeah, they're getting Mason.
First one up and hangs on the rim, no good. Seconds left to play here in the opening half. Second one up and good. 17-16. Good idea to pull it out there. So Rivers will have the last shot with 10. Down to 5. Schroeder just about outside the free throw line. No. And Ben Carter with the last second heave. Whoa. No good. Metamora with the 1-point lead going into the halftime break. 17-16. Pretty sloppy first half by Metamora.
It was.
So we will step aside. We'll come back with the second half and the first half stats. Back into the broadcast here. We're at halftime of Metamora and Morton and tonight's Mid-Illini Conference matchup, the final Mid-Illini Conference matchup of the 2021-22 season. Metamora with the 17-16 lead at the half. Redbirds led by Zach Schroeder with 7 points. Other than that, it's very sporadic. Matthew Zobrist with 1 3-point shot on 1 of 2 shooting. Ethan Kaiser, 2 points on 1 of 3 shooting. Tyson Swanson, 3 points on 1 of 4 shooting, 1 of 2 from the free throw line. Drew Tucker, 2 points, 1 of 4 shooting. For Morton, Lane Kaufman is their leading scorer. with 9 points for Kaufman here in the
little surprise
first half. Yeah, very
little,
surprising.
A little surprising looking up there and seeing Bo Durbin with no points.
Yeah, but I don't think Bo's attempted a shot tonight.
Yeah, he had that clinker that he missed the layup.
Oh, that's right. Very surprising to see him, but other than that, Gus Rugard 3 points, Seth Glatz with 2 points, Tate Rowley with 2 points, Seth Glatz with two fouls for Morton in the first half. No one for Metamora in foul trouble.
No.
Tyson Swanson had 4 rebounds in the first half, along with Zach Schroeder with 4 rebounds.
Ethan Kaiser with 3. Michael Zobrist in a block, and Matthew Zobrist with
a rebound and a block.
Yeah, I had him for 2 rebounds, and he had that block, nice
recovery block.
Yeah,
it'll be Metamora ball here to start the third quarter. Very slow offensive night. Another good crowd here tonight. On hand to witness a good basketball game. And while there hasn't been a whole lot of scoring, it's tight here through the first two quarters.
Yep, Redbirds.
I'd like to give a happy birthday shout out to Mark Nealon today.
Yep. And wish his wife a speedy recovery, had surgery today. Bridget, kind of the team mom.
Yes. One of the nicest people you'll ever meet.
Yep.
So Redbirds out with the starting lineup of Schroeder, Zobrist, Tucker, Swanson, Kaiser. Matthew Zobrist gonna pull up just inside the 3-point line, can't get it to go.
Boy, it looked good going up. Boy, that mid-range jump shot, I think he's gonna be one of those guys that kind of lives on that.
If you can add a fifth element to this team and boy, it just make him even more dangerous. Deep three, Gus Rugard up and good.
That gives them the 2-point lead, 19-17.
That was very deep there. Metamora's got to find their flow. They really have yet to do that all night. Schroeder on the pump fake. Up left hand, no good.
We're just a little bit off.
Had to fight through a little bit of contact. Been the story of the night. 3 on the way, Lane Kaufman, no.
Kaiser with another rebound.
Quickly, the other way. Swanson, right hand, up and in. I thought it was gonna bounce out.
Yeah, Kaiser was there.
But he got it, ties it up at 19, 6:33 left to play here in the third quarter.
Pretty glad that Kaiser just let that go.
Good help defense there from Tyson Swanson. Metamora wants the 3-second call. Durbin can't get it.
Schroeder with his 5th rebound.
Schroeder drive, kick, Zobrist open 3.
Got it to roll.
The members bounce. Matthew Zobrist, 22-19, 5:45. Looked short the entire way, but got a great bounce.
Shooters roll.
Ben Carter on the drive, got the arm of Ethan Kaiser. And it really was, say, it was Carter's arm going over the top. It, you know, it's a mute point. That's Kaiser's 2nd foul. Carter will get 2 regardless.
Yeah. 5:23, third quarter. 22-19 Redbirds.
First one up and short. So they have to say, ball doesn't lie.
Yep.
And 2nd one clanks. Ooh. All right, we'll take it.
Yeah, I think that was probably knocked out by Morton because Kaiser had it and somebody had to come and knock it from him. Kaiser will bring it up.
Referee was confident in his call, so we'll go with it.
Yep.
As long as you're confident, more times than not, you can sell it. Zobrist, not sure if he had it. Obviously had it poked away, but deep three, Carter. No, rebound, Kaiser.
Kaiser's presence made Bo Durbin not want to shoot that ball.
Zobrist drive and kick. Tucker to the baseline, no. Rebound, Schroeder. His shot up, no good. And Morton, I mean, just banging down low. No calls.
Boy, I don't know.
I'm not sure what more you have to do at this point. They're going to go underneath to Rolly. Kicks it out. Kaufman, three. Short. Rebound, Kaiser. His sixth on the evening. Quickly other way is Kaiser. Little two-man game there, and they got the hold on Kaufman.
That was a great post up by Kaiser, though. I love that. Boy, I'd like to see him do that a lot more.
Got position on a matchup he likes.
Mason comes in for Zobrist. 22-19 Redbirds. 4 minutes, 8 seconds to go.
Swanson, right hand, couldn't get it. Great defense there from Carter.
And oh, he traveled.
Yep.
And that'll be a mass break.
So a 3:58 left to play. Break. 22-19 is the Metamora lead. And Matt Franks did not like the call. I'm not sure if it was a call tonight. He has liked.
He liked the ones that go for Morton. Boy, a nice crowd again here tonight, isn't it?
Yes, it's a big night. If you're not tuning in on
MTCO
here, you could be tuning in on ESPN Radio. 101.1 ESPN Peoria. Clutch Sports has that broadcast here tonight. Got the pep band here tonight. Another good night of the couples cheer and the couples dance at the halftime break. Got even a little half-court shooting. No one made the half-court tonight, so no free pizza. You know, they at Bradley games, they do if you make a layup, you get free ribs. If you make a three-pointer, your section gets free ribs. If you make a half quarter, everyone in the building gets free ribs. And I finally saw someone get to where their section gets free ribs. I'm telling you, if they selected me, that entire place would be, Carver Arena would be walking home with free ribs. I'm telling you right now.
Cooked?
Yes.
Redbird ball after the media timeout.
Although I'm not sure I'd want my ribs from Carver Arena. Not sure who the sponsor is on that one. But hey, free ribs, I'm in. Schroeder, good dump down pass underneath to Kaiser.
Oh, yeah.
And they get the foul call.
Kaiser will get a rebound for that, too.
Padding the stats a little bit.
He's just getting pounded underneath there. I think he got fouled on his first shot, didn't he?
Yeah, there's been quite a few tonight that have could have had some whistles, but see third foul on Seth Glatz.
Ethan's got to make these. And nothing but net.
Has Glatz committed anywhere to football yet? I don't believe so.
I don't think so.
All-state running back.
Oh, what a Tyson job by Tyson Swanson.
With the tough rebound.
Oh,
Ethan,
yeah.
Kaiser with the layup. Makes it 25-19.
That was all set up by Tyson Swanson with just a muscle rebound.
3:20 left to play here. Bo Durbin on the drive, looking. Gus Rugard again from deep, no.
Oh, good rebound by Schroeder.
His seventh of the evening. He gets it back. Open lane, tough shot.
No, and it goes in.
Zach Schroeder, Metamora on a little bit of a run here.
27-19 Redbirds.
Morton's going to get a timeout.
2:46 to go, third quarter. Redbirds up 27-19. Wow, you're right. Metamora's a little more aggressive this quarter than they were that first half.
Getting to the basket, and they're making a conservative effort to get down low. Not that they weren't in the first half. They're just finding more open lanes.
Yeah. Colton, Metamora gets the number one seed in their regional. They'll play Richwoods at Richwoods next, was it next Tuesday night or Monday?
Tuesday, I believe.
Tuesday. And Richwoods?
It might be Monday.
Richwoods, a pretty solid team.
No, they play next Wednesday night.
Next Wednesday night, okay.
Yep, because it'll be Wednesday, Friday.
Okay.
Last time the Redbirds and Knights met in the regional semifinal, Redbirds won that one in a
At Washington.
That was a interesting ball game.
Oh, nice job by
Morton. Turns it over.
Nice job by Tyson Swanson. Just wants the ball a little bit more than everybody
Tyler
else.
Tyler Mason open three.
Got it.
Rattles around. Finds its way in. Tyler
30,
Mason.
30-19.
Seth Glatz on the drive, had it slapped away, but right back to him. Probably could have been his fourth foul right there. I thought Schroeder was in front of him to pick up the charge. Drew Tucker goes right by him, and there's a foul.
I love that.
There's the fourth foul from Glatz.
Drew Tucker is not afraid of anybody. He goes right down the lane. He knows he's going to get clobbered because he does every single game.
First one up and good. Can you imagine if Drew threw that down on top of Glatz?
Oh.
Another big dunk on Morton.
And he gets them both, 32-21 Redbirds, 207. Largest lead of the game for the Birds.
That would have been a lumpy Vogel-esque dropping it down there.
Yep. I believe that is a foul, but man, they're getting their hands on a lot of basketballs right now.
It's the third on Kaiser. Luke Hopp up off the bench. So Kaiser will have a seat.
Probably sit the rest of the third quarter.
Gus Rugard, three. Can't get it.
Hop
rebound
with
Hop. Ball always finds a
new
if
guy.
It finds you.
So you got two juniors, two sophomores, and a senior out there. And we've been younger on the floor.
Good entry pass. Swanson, turn around.
Oh, my.
Right hook. Makes it 34-21. 1:20 left to play. Bo Durbin's been very quiet tonight for the Potters. Still no points on two shots. He hasn't been aggressive enough, in my opinion, for knowing Bo Durbin and his style of play. He's in amongst the trees.
He traveled. It's just been great defense on him.
You know, I've seen him go off for 30-plus points against Metamora multiple times.
Yes. 1 minute to go here in the third quarter. Redbirds up 34-21.
They get it to Mason. They've got numbers. Swanson, corner three.
Good!
Rattles home. Makes it 37-21. 44 kicks left to play here in the third quarter. Metamora extending this lead. See, that's one Bert Durbin's got to find his shot.
Hop with the rebound.
With the rebound.
I think that was partially blocked, too. So Redbirds will. You're right.
He had a wide open lane there.
Yeah. Metamora will wait.
He's trying to make the unselfish move of finding his teammate, but be a little bit more selfish and score the ball. They're going to find Schroeder on the drive. Had it blocked by Carter.
Oh, he traveled.
There'll be 0.2 left on the clock. You bring Ethan back in for a tip play?
No.
That's all you're going to get.
Yeah, that's all you're going to get. But I would set this up for Tyson Swanson.
At the buzzer, oh. No. Good idea there from Lou Kopp.
Yep, not a bad idea. Kaiser will come back in. Into the third quarter, Redbirds lead 37-21. Take this time to thank our sponsors. Angie Powers with Keller Williams Premier Realty, Black and Brown Attorneys, Commerce Bank, Kevin Kyle and Edward Jones, Germantown Grill, we'll be going there. Goodfield State Bank, Logo Wear, Mason Funeral Home, Metamora McDonald's, Michael's Italian Feast, MVP DJ Service, Snyder Village, and Zobrist Insurance. Maybe tomorrow. Boy, that was a pretty good third quarter for the Redbirds.
Very good third quarter.
16-point lead. They came out of the halftime locker room with just a 1-point lead. So
it really wasn't even, it was about the last 3 minutes, really, more than anything. Morton called a timeout with about a little over 3 minutes left. And since then, Metamora has just turned the Jets on.
A 20-5 run?
Yes.
It'll be Morton Ball to start this fourth quarter. Nice hedge.
Ben Carter on the drive. Tough finish, can't get it to go. Rugard's there. Carter again. Oh. Third time's the charm. Ben Carter.
37-23.
His first 2 points of the evening. Metamora's got numbers the other way. That was kicked.
Yep.
But it's off Rugard no matter what.
Yep.
It'll stay with the Redbirds on the sideline.
14-point lead for the Birds. Like you said, 37-23.
That's just a bad pass there.
Oh, nice defense.
Ben Carter for three. Too strong, rebound Kaiser.
Oh, how'd he get it back? Oh, he saved it.
Turn it over.
Pretty good effort by Morton there. That's a really good effort.
Got to be smarter with the ball. Rugard drive, layup, got it.
37-25.
Coach Graves is going to get a timeout. He's not going to be happy with his team.
No.
37-25, 6:54 left to play in the game. This isn't much of a timeout to Rick. It's just vents of frustration here from Coach Graves.
Yeah.
Just being careless with the ball, allowing Morton to get a quick little 4-0 run.
Metamora stays with the same players they had before the timeout.
Kaufman pressuring Tucker. Drew goes quickly the other way.
Oh.
Layup short.
I like that move, though, right to the basket.
Tate Rowley going to spot up for three. No
Schroeder good. With another rebound.
His eighth. Schroeder closing in on a double-double. Miscommunication there, another turnover. Fans growing restless here at Tepke Gym. Three good, Carter.
That makes it 37-28. Metamora needs a bucket.
7-0 run by the Potters. Tyler Mason, a spot up for three. No, rebound Kaiser.
His ninth.
I have him for eight. It's close.
Yeah.
They're going inside to Swanson, kicks it out. Bo Durbin bit on the pass. Wasn't able to come up with anything. That one was tipped. Tucker at the charge, yep. That'll be his first foul. Morton trying to climb back in this one. 5:09 left to play, 37-28.
I'd like to see him stop and just do the little teardrop. Redbirds have to play some defense.
Bo Durbin kicks. He traveled. Ben Carter three. No. Tipped. Schroeder with the board. And he was fouled.
That was a pretty crafty move by Zach Schroeder.
Schroeder's ninth rebound on the night. So a point and a rebound away from a double-double for Zach Schroeder. Four 30, 37-28. They're gonna double. It's not a good move. Smart by Mason to pull that one back out. No sense in forcing anything. Tucker gonna drive, layup, got
it. And good.
Drew Tucker right around Bo Durbin. Stops the bleeding. And the first basket for Metamora almost halfway through. Next dead ball will be our media timeout. They're going around. Open three, Gudeman. Got it.
Got it.
Wes Gudeman. Yeah, that's going to get a timeout out of Morton. 39-31. This is an 8-point game all of a sudden. Morton on a 10-2 run here in the first 4 minutes.
And I still think Metamora is...
They got comfortable.
A little bit comfortable. I think we're still okay. We just have to take good care of the ball and make sure that we make free throws.
Elsewhere around the middle line eye tonight, you had Limestone at Canton, Dunlap at East Peoria, and Pekin at Washington. Scott, this team continues to climb the ranks. They could be have the second most wins of any program by the end of the regular season, assuming we play that game on Thursday night.
Yep.
They win here tonight and win on Thursday.
Well, they will have played the most games, too.
True. But 23-6 on the year is very impressive. Coach Greaves continues his phenomenal record here at Metamora, 222-91.
Wow. So it'll be Redbird ball after the timeout. 39-31 Redbirds. 3:52.
Kaiser, and they leak it to Tucker. He was fouled. On Kaufman. Metamora wants the intentional. I thought he was going for the ball.
And he cans the first. That was a great outlet pass to Drew. 40-31.
Coach Bond getting a talking to from Ron King there. 41-31, lead back to 10.
3:45 to go in the ball game.
Durbin on the drive, oh, he traveled. Shuffled the feet, but got fouled by Tucker.
Yep.
Got Tucker up in the air. Smack across the arm, and Durbin will go to the line. That's the first time I've really seen Durbin be aggressive tonight.
Yeah, yeah.
And he misses the first. Excuse me.
Wow. I wonder if he's been sick. This is not the Bo Durbin we've come to.
Mesa second. So he's finally in the scoring column. 41-32. A player that is not on the roster sheet comes in the game number two. Coach Greaves is going to call a timeout. 30-second timeout.
3:34 to go in the ballgame. Redbirds up 41-32.
You know, looking back, each coach used to get seven timeouts. Each team, seven timeouts. And there are so many timeouts. Now, you get that first timeout after the four-minute mark, first dead ball. Metamora has used two timeouts, and Morton has used two timeouts.
The game seemed to go a little bit quicker with that automatic timeout in there.
Last night, Washington, the girls, they didn't use a timeout until they got into overtime,
yeah,
I believe.
Yeah.
They may have used one in regulation and it was late, but
I think they might have used one in regular. You're right, one.
Zach Schroeder inbound the ball. Everyone releases. Brings Tyler Mason back, and they get to Tucker. They throw it ahead. They get it across. Good pressure from Morton. We saw Morton force pressure against Notre Dame in their comeback win.
And they got a lot of turnovers against Notre Dame. They forced Notre Dame. Notre Dame had a lead, and they forced Notre Dame to turn the ball over quite a bit, and they came back and won that game. Was it 53-52?
Yes. Fouls on number two. Metamora in the bonus. No travel, no nothing. Probably could have been a foul, and they're going to get a reach there.
Boy, there was some Durbin. Ugly play in there, wasn't there?
Yeah, it wasn't pretty, no. So Tyson Swanson will go to the line for 1-1. No, excuse me, Zach Schroeder. I could have swore that was Swanson. First one up and good. Is it 42-32?
3:13 to go in the ball game.
A And the second one up and good.
43-32, 3:13 to go.
Zach Schroeder's got to be the best free throw shooter on the team, yes.
Him or Swanson, but Swanson had, what, 142 in a row?
Yeah.
In practice?
But it seems like in-game, very few times, very so often, does Zach Schroeder ever miss.
Yeah, you're
he's
right.
6 for 6 tonight.
He's money. He's a money player. Good players, they rise at the end of the games.
3 on the way, is up and good.
Is that Glatz?
That's Glatz. Zach Schroeder was trying to bark out commands to his team and lost Glatz in the corner.
Oh, nice job by Schroeder.
Oh, Tyson Swanson wide open.
Oh, good. Oh, that's some great ball movement there.
That's going to be the fifth foul on Seth Glatz. Great job on the pump fake there. Tyson Swanson, he'll have a chance to make it a three-point play.
He just waited for that first guy to go by, and then he just laid it up and in.
Free throw up, no good.
45-35, 2:25 to go in the ball game. Boy, every time Morton makes a nice hedge by Swanson, we do that as well as anybody in high school.
Ben Carter open three, too strong, but the rebound goes to Rowley. Gus Rugard gonna try his luck, got it.
Wow.
That's deep there from Rugard, his second three ball of the half, makes it 45-38, timeout Morton. 2:08 left to play, Redbirds holding on to that 7-point lead. It's a full timeout for the Potters. Long rebounds create second chance opportunities, and Morton's been able to cash in tonight.
2:08 to go. Redbirds with that 7-point lead and the ball.
Score update in the third quarter. In Canton, Little Giants down 6 to Limestone, 37-31. Senior night there.
You know, could Canton make some noise in 2A? They played a pretty tough
no.
Middle Illinois schedule.
I don't think they have enough.
Yeah, they play smaller schools. You just wonder if they could maybe make some noise. About 2:08 to go here, Colton. Metamora has to take care of the ball and be smart.
Oh, had Tucker again on the leak.
I'm guessing he would have gotten fouled hard.
And they got a jump.
Ooh.
Morton fans not happy about that one.
You know, they did tie him up.
They get Mason. There's a lot just not being called. They get one there on Rugard. So that'll send Mason to the line for one in bonus. One more and Redbirds will be in double bonus. Was the fourth foul there on Lane Kaufman.
Gets first the first.
Up. Yep, first one up and good.
46-38, 1:50 to go.
Second one up and rattles in. A They're getting Mason on a cheap one.
Yep. I think he did grab him. Pretty good defense.
Almost threw that one away. Ben Carter, three, is just off the front iron.
Mason with the rebound.
They're going to get the foul there on Wes Gudeman. That's the 10th.
1:29 to go. And that'll send Schroeder to the line for two.
Schroeder may come up one rebound short of a double-double here tonight. Very good performances from him and Tyson Swanson here tonight. Schroeder's just been big down the stretch of this season.
Yeah. He's a senior.
First one up and good.
Sense of urgency.
Kicks in 48-38 on the first made free throw. Second one up and good as well. So 11-point lead. Morton's got to go quick. Durbin pull up three. No in. There it is. The double-double. Zach Schroeder. We'll just go ahead and get it over with. Zach Schroeder, tonight's MTCO digiMAX player of the game.
Yeah.
13 points, 10 rebounds so far for Schroeder on the evening.
What a great way to finish out the season at home. Play your second biggest rival.
24-6. Redbirds could move too. We're at 12-point game now with 1:10.
I think I told you we'd win by 12.
And second one, make it 13. And make it 15 for Schroeder on the evening. Durbin quickly the other way. He's looking. Swanson.
It's a foul on Swanson.
Yep. So Durbin will go the line to shoot two.
Durbin with 1 point tonight.
First one up and good. And he is a senior, correct?
Yeah. Yes.
Second one up and good as well. 11-point lead. 1 minute. Back to Schroeder, throws it to Swanson. And a foul there on Hudson Strube. First one up and good. If Morton walks off the court early tonight, are we going to dunk it again?
Oh, of course.
I'd hope maybe they learned their lesson after last time. We'll see.
Did they hit a three down here?
No.
Is that score right?
I have 52-40. No, that's right, because, Durbin hit both free throws.
Is that Schroeder that got the rebound?
Yes. Actually, no, I think it was Swanson.
Six. Yeah, Swanson got fouled, so. Up and good. and he gets the second. 54-42 with just under 45 seconds to go.
Three on the way, no good from Rolly.
I'll send Durbin back to the line.
First one up and rattles in. It's been a long last minute 30.
Yeah, it has. 39 seconds to go. Redbirds up 54-43.
Make it 44. Oh, Miss Tucker. He finds Mason. Durbin's going to get it. And Tucker will go to the line to shoot two. First one up and good from Tucker. And second one up and good.
56-44, under 30 seconds to go.
Ben Carter, deep three, is airballed. We'll get a line change here for the Potters. And a line change for the Redbirds.
I think all the seniors are coming in. So it'll be Solomon Suarez, Luke DeFrance, Kaiser Quick, and Jake Nealon come in for the Redbirds. Zach Schroeder stays out there with the rest of the seniors.
Get this final 20 seconds off the clock. Six, and Metamora will dribble this one out. 24-6, the Redbirds move on in the year. Finish the Mid Illini with a 13-1 record. Mid Illini champs. And tonight's final score, 56-44. We'll take a break. We will step aside and we'll come back with the very happy head coach, Danny Greaves. Welcome back to Tepke Gym. We're here with head coach Danny Greaves. Coach, just a great performance by your guys tonight. They pull out the 12-point victory, 56-44. I talked to Scott, and he kind of mentioned it a little bit in the pregame with you on kind of the attitude of the team coming into this one because he had already clinched. Was it going to be, you know, were they come out with pride or were they going to come out with a little bit of formality? But there was a lot of pride in this one for your guys here tonight.
Well, it's funny you say that. You know, we always put keys of the game up on the board and talk about a lot of different things, but number one was on pride. It was a pride game. It didn't matter whether we were Mid Illini champs or the game was on the line. You know, we just have a lot of pride in how we play, and you know what, we just trying to get better and get ready for the postseason. And I told our guys, I said, you know, with that effort, we definitely did. I thought it was a great ball game. I'll tell you what, they did a really good job. They did all they can to try to beat us, and our kids are just better tonight.
Just great performances all around. I want to start with your defense because the point that you made, you know, coming up, Bo Durbin, only 5 points on 5 of 6 from the free throw line. I think he only attempted 3 shots all night. Very uncommon for him because he's a guy that's been able to score a little bit against us in the past.
Well, last year I think he averaged 30 points a game.
Yeah.
But we put a little height on him. You know, I tell you what, I thought that, you know, the different guys we had on him all night long, but you got to give it to Drew Tucker, man. He was in his tail all night long. You couldn't get it off. And we walled up. You know, the one time he jumped down right in front of the rim, and the kid got 2 free throws off it. But it's, you know, you talk about a heck of a hand. That kid, I don't know if he's ever had a high school game where he didn't have at least 1 bucket.
Right. And, you know, you look at a series between these two teams, and it's one that's always pretty well resulted in a good game. Coming off the last game and the way things ended, but your guys took care of business here tonight. I mean, Zach Schroeder, just big, 15 points, 10 boards to lead the way. Just he's really turned on the Jets here late.
They just didn't have an answer for him. You know, that kid is really coming on and playing some fantastic basketball. You know, and you could just tell his leadership on the court, running our offense, getting guys all organized on defense. It's really fun to watch him play.
Tyson Swanson continues his great play, 15 points. He's just been consistent really all year.
Well, I thought it was great in the fact that the other night they double, triple, and quadruple teamed him, and it didn't bother him. You know, he just gave the ball up with no reluctance and spread the wealth with the basketball. We got so many guys that can do something with it. So, you know, and I just told our guys, some of our biggest things, that positives that we have going right now is our unselfish play.
You have the core four of Schroeder, Kaiser, Swanson, and Tucker. But one guy that just doesn't seem that the moment's too big for him or the light's too bright, Matthew Zobrist, the back last two games, arguably the toughest two games as a freshman to start in big moments, and he's shined a little bit.
Well, as far as the end of the season, you know, toughest games, you're right. Washington and Morton back-to-back, and he came in, and he's done a tremendous job. Not only just shooting the ball, but I'll tell you what, he's done an excellent job defending and rebounding.
And you look forward, you have the game hopefully on Thursday night at IVC to finish out the regular season. The one seed in the subsectional, one seed in the regional, at Richwoods next Wednesday against Richwoods, the host team. Things were a little interesting last time we played them in the regional.
That was one of the craziest games you ever saw, wasn't it? And as crazy as that game was, then you play Washington to
triple overtime the next
night. Was even nuttier. So, you know, we had a chance to drive down to Danville and watch them play on Saturday. Hadn't had a chance to see them all year long. We got plenty of film on them. They're a lot like the team that we beat in 2018. And, you know, they run a lot of the same stuff. And I think even though we're a one seed and they're a six, you know, where we should get a 16 seed, I think it's a decent draw for us.
Coach, we'll wrap things up. Just a great win for your guys tonight. They tie the program record of most conference wins at 13-1. Middle Illinois champs again. It still sounds good.
It sounds great.
Coach, thanks. We'll let you go, and we'll hopefully see you on Thursday night.
Thank you so much. Appreciate you guys for everything you do.
That'll do it for us here tonight from Tepke Gym. Just another great outing by Metamora here tonight with the Redbirds winning 56-44. Zach Schroeder, our MTCO digiMAX Sports Player of the Game, 15 points, 10 rebounds. And for Scott Kirker, Tom Hagen on the camera, Mark Goodyear, Bob Beecraft, Kip Dubois, everyone back up at MTCO. This is Colton Kaler signing off on a Redbird winner here from Tepke Gym.